Welcome to the first ever interview data community for one of our upcoming events. On Tuesday is Data Visualization DC at Agency Chief. Agency Chief has been awesome for all of 2016 hosting us. They are a digital agency that does everything from run your website to design digital media campaigns. And they have an incredible staff, and they have a great, incredible footprint here in the DC area. So I'm really excited to be working with them. And you know, there's the NVIDIA GPU conference that's coming up, and Data Community has a code for y'all. You can find it on our website, and it'll be listed down below in a little bit. But without further ado, I'd like to introduce Michael Flynn, or just Flynn. Wave hi, Michael. You just did.
Hello.
And, you know, I'd like, why don't you introduce yourself?
Oh, I'm Flynn, and I am a graduate student at the Johns Hopkins University. I am currently researching video processing, applying convolutional neural networks to video processing and video understanding. And I don't know what else I should say about myself.
Whatever you want, whatever you're comfortable with. This is kind of ad hoc here.
Okay. So,
you know, there's this, it's kind of funny how we reached out. So I helped to organize a deep learning workshop here in the DC area, which is currently being hosted by Comcast. And I'm part of a number of different Google groups in order to kind of stay up to date with all the different techniques, the different code that's out there, what people are saying is good or not good. And I came across your profile, and I forget exactly what it is that you said, but it caught my eye. And then I went and looked at your profile, and you had that animated GIF. I almost wish we could pull it up here, but let's not get too crazy yet. And then I saw you're up in Baltimore, at Johns Hopkins, and so I reached out, and things are working out so far, so I'm pretty excited about that. So how did you create that animated GIF? I think I'll post it when I post this video so everybody can see it.
So that animated GIF was the result of an experiment I was doing with convolutional networks, or specifically they are deconvolutional networks, where the idea is that you basically tell the network a description of what you want to draw, and then it will create the image for you from a few parameters. And what I did is I trained it on a set of faces that were a bunch of different identities and a bunch of different emotions and a bunch of orientations, and I tried to interpolate between them, which produced some pretty uncanny, pretty wild results as well.
You just said, tell it what to draw.
Yeah.
I mean, how? draw me a face. I want somebody who looks angry. Like, how do you tell a computer I want somebody that looks sad or angry or, you know, incredulous?
Well, essentially, for each image, you have different labels of like which person it is and which emotion they're displaying, and you can represent these as one of K encodings, which is basically vectors that are all zeros, but in the nth position for the nth person that you want to represent, you would just put a one there. That would give the network an idea of what sort of person.
So it's almost like you give it some waypoints or something like that, some like anchors that it has to build around. In the vector embeddings, in the vector embeddings. What's it called? The character encodings.
Essentially. And it also lets you do some interesting things. Like you can say, essentially, every time you're doing it, you're saying, I want 100% of this person. And then when you interpolate, you slowly go from, I want 100% of this person to, I want 100% of just this other person. Mm-hmm. And then you can do really wild things, like say, yeah, and then you can do wild things like, what if you want 200% of this person, or what if you want everyone? And that's where it really starts to get interesting, because then the network starts to generate some very pretty creepy images, which you can probably see on that meetup page.
So it's not waypoints. So when I was saying waypoints, I was thinking something different, like points on the face. But you're talking about like basically doing interpolations between the different faces that you've used in order to train the network in the first place.
Yeah. So they are high level labels to describe the whole image.
Yeah, there's another technique that reminds me of that I'm trying to remember right now that would do the interpolation on a subpixeled image, right? And then it would try to fill in the spaces between it. But I'll probably remember after this call is over. and I remember we were just talking before this whole thing started that this came out of your own journal club that you were doing, and you wanted to kind of have a way to visualize each of the different layers of the network.
Well, there was a deep learning reading group at Hopkins that I was part of, one of the papers that I read for it was basically they were doing the same thing but with chairs, the little 3D generated chairs. And I was wondering, one, could this be applied to something, to more natural images like human faces? And then two, what happens if you visualize all the intermediate levels? Can you actually see what the network is thinking when it's trying to actually build a face? Because usually people, typically when they teach computer vision, they always say that it's such a hard problem because all the computer can see is numbers. But then the reason it's a hard problem for people to understand computer vision is that all we see is numbers. We don't actually get to see images. So this is a very interesting way to kind of intuitively build an understanding about convolutional networks.
That's pretty cool. Yeah, I get these comments all the time that you can't really see what's going on in between the different layers, and this is going to be a prime example of that. You can see the progression in between things, so it's going to be fun to see it. Yeah, so I'm excited for the event. It's usually pretty open, not that much different than what we're doing right now, except that there'll be 100 or so people there. Mm-hmm. So we'll have a chance to just kind of wrap back and forth with people as they have questions throughout the day. So throughout the evening, everybody will have at least one beer in them, hopefully, thanks to Chief. So any other thoughts, any other messages before we sign off?
It'll be really fun. You should all come to it. And I think it'll be interesting. It'll be definitely something different than what you're used to from data visualization, I think.
All right. Well, thank you very much. And thanks, Tony, for doing this. And we'll see everybody at Data Visualization DC Tuesday at Chief. Bye-bye.